So I want to touch upon some basics of a PN junction or a PN diode in this video. So one way to think about this PN junction is to think about these individually doped P and N regions. So I have these two semiconductor blocks. One is N-type and it has essentially donor atoms which are added to this to the lattice of the semiconductor, and they have this extra electron which is given to the lattice, and they in what it results in is results in this XX population of electrons which are present in the conduction band of this N-type semiconductor. Similarly, in P-type semiconductor, we're using the same analogy. What we do over here is we add these acceptor atoms which have one less electrons as what is needed to complete the bonding in the lattice. So that produces absence of electrons which are represented as the holes present in the valence band. So now a good way to think about how this PN junction works is to think about when we have these individual PN N-type semiconductor. Essentially what I'm doing is I'm bringing them, I'm bringing them closer and closer, and I'm bringing them in contact with each other. So now what happens if I essentially put these two in contact? So let me think of in terms of these carriers. So I have these electrons, excess electrons over here. So there are plenty of electrons in the N-type semiconductor. While there are no electrons, or there are absence of electrons in the P-type semiconductor. So these guys which are present in excess over here, they would very much like to go into this P-type semiconductor, because if you think about the excess of these electrons over here, and they think they'll be more valued if they go to some place where there is a need of electrons or there is a absence of electrons. So these if we think of in terms of electrons, these electrons want to jump from these N-type to the P-type semiconductor. Similarly, if I think of it in terms of these holes, so there are a lot of these holes present in the P-type semiconductor, while there are no holes, or very less holes which are present in the N-type semiconductor. So these holes, they want to jump over to the N-type semiconductor where they think they'll be valued more. So this results in immediate exchange of carriers. So these electrons go from here to here, and this holes go from P-type to the N-type semiconductor, and finally we reach a state of equilibrium. So let me explain why this equilibrium happens. So when these electrons leave from these from the N-type semiconductor and they go to the P-type semiconductor, what they leave behind is these positively charged donor atoms. Remember that we had these donor atoms over here and acceptor atoms in the P-type semiconductor. So what they leave behind is this positively charged donor atoms. And similarly, when these holes which jump from the P-type semiconductor to the N-type semiconductor, what they leave behind is this acceptors over here, which are negatively charged. So they leave behind these negatively charged acceptor atoms. And this happens in a certain region, which is what is called as a depletion width. So let me denote this depletion width on the P-type semiconductor with this letter X with a subscript P. Similarly, I can denote the depletion region in the N-type semiconductor with this letter X and a subscript N. So now let's see what has happened over here. So I have these holes which are present in the P-type semiconductor. They want to diffuse to the N-type region, but now there's a security guard, this positively charged donor atoms which are standing over here, and these holes are positively charged as well. So there's a repulsion between these holes and these positively charged donor atoms, and they keep holes present in the P-type semiconductor, they keep them in check and prevent them to further diffusing into the N-type semiconductor. Similarly, if I think in terms of these holes which are now present in the N-type semiconductor, so they again want to go to the P-type semiconductor, but again there's this security guard, this negatively charged acceptor atoms, and since these electrons are negatively charged as well, so there's repulsive force between these two that prevents further diffusion of these carriers, and this is what is called as we have reached the equilibrium state. So now let me, you know, let me think what happens in the equilibrium state. What is the electric field? What is the potential profile? So if I think, let me start with first this in terms of this charge profile. So if I think of this charge profile, or the charge which is present in the semiconductor, so what I have just stated is that the charge in this depletion region on the p-type on the p-type is essentially equal to this negative times the concentration of the acceptors, and similarly the charge present on the n-type is equal to this positively charged donor atoms which are left behind. And charge neutrality must hold true. So basically, you know, what is the total charge present in this region must be equal to the total charge which is present in this upper rectangle. So that gives me my first equation, that is my charge neutrality, which is this concentration of donors into the depletion width on the n-type region, and this must be equal to the concentrations of acceptors multiplied by the depletion width in the p-type region. So what I'm doing is essentially equating the area under these two rectangles, and that must hold true because overall there's no net charge which was added or removed from this p-n junction. And I've made this further approximation that I've assumed that, you know, whatever is the charge is present in just this depletion region. There's no charge present outside this depletion region, and this approximation is what is called as a depletion approximation. So making this depletion approximation, I can write the charge neutrality, I can express that in terms of this equation. So now the next thing for me to do is to relate this charge density or this charge profile. And I can use some, you know, some basic physics I learned in the high school to relate it to the electric field and relate it to the potential profile which is present in this PN diode. So how can I do that? So I know from my high school physics that my charge density is related to the electric field using this relationship, where it's dependent on my electric field. The derivative of my electric field is dependent upon the charge density divided by the dielectric constant of my semiconductor and the permittivity in the free space. I also know that my electric field is related to my potential profile by again this relationship. So what I can do is integrate my charge profile, and that will give me the profile of my electric field, and then I can integrate my electric field, and that will give me the potential profile. So when I integrate over this charge profile, so I have this constant charge density in my depletion region, which is negative in the p-type region and positive in the n-type region. So when I integrate this rectangle, what I'll get is this triangle over here, and I'll get a maximum electric field which would be essentially equal to this total charge present in the p-type region, which would be equal to nd times xp, and then using this Poisson relationship I'll get that maximum electric field to be this, and which is also I can express that using this charge neutrality condition in terms of the total charge present in the n-type region, and both are the same. So this is my this is my maximum electric field. Let me correct this mistake over here. So this should be xn. And then when I integrate, I see that I have a maximum electric field which just occurs at the junction, right at the junction between the p and n-type semiconductor. And this this electric field again, it reduces as I further travel into the n-type semiconductor. And you see that outside the depletion region, there's no electric field. And we can also relate to that by this charge profile. So these charged total charge which is present in the p and n type region are equal and opposite to each other. So if I think of the total charge present outside this depletion region, that's again zero. So that makes sense that there would be no electric field present outside this depletion region. And now I can integrate this triangle further. So I can integrate this triangle. So this triangle is essentially a linear relationship. And when I get when I integrate it, I'll get a square relationship in terms of my distance. So when I integrate this electric field, what I'll get is this total potential drop up across my PN junction, and I can denote that by this symbol VBI, where it represents the built-in voltage across my PN junction. And this VBI is essentially given by this relationship, where I get a square in terms of my length, of my depletion width, and I get a factor of 2, which comes from integrating this. And this is essentially gives me this VBI in terms of the doping concentration and the depletion width. So now I have two relationships. So I have this is my equation number 1, and this is my equation number 2. And I have two variables, xn and xp. And I have two equations, two variables. So let me complete their solution in the next video.